Now to a story that affects your health, and if you're a Lancaster City resident, your wallet as well. We're talking about the problems at the city's wastewater treatment plant. City officials say about 100 times a year, some wastewater gets dumped directly into the Conestoga River, which eventually then makes its way to the Chesapeake Bay. The city's been fined for accidents 6 times in the last 2 years, and that cost does get passed on to residents. And we now know even more wastewater is going to be pumped to that facility. News 8's Lancaster reporter Caitlin Smith toured the plant today to find out how it plans to handle the increase.
And that's the beginning of the plant,
where an average of 21 million gallons of rainwater and wastewater pour in each day before being filtered out. 10 municipalities use the wastewater treatment plant in Lancaster. Each one is allowed a certain capacity, and right now, none uses it all.
So we saw what it is coming in here, how mucky it is, and then see what it is at the end of the plant. I mean, it's cleaner than what's in the Conestoga River.
Except when the plant is forced to put dirty water into the Conestoga. That happens during heavy rains when it takes on more than twice its average amount. It happens because most of the equipment is 30 years old. Right now, more than $10 million worth of construction is underway at the plant.
You see the increases in sewer rates, and it's because of all the upgrades that we have to make.
But there are times when wastewater gets into the river because of a mistake. On July 9th, it was nearly 3 million gallons of raw sewage.
There was one major spill that was an operator error.
This is called an alarm dialer. It's what notifies workers here at the plant when there's a problem. But while some were doing repair work, they shut it off and forgot to turn it back on.
The operator was suspended, so there were actions taken to try and not to prevent that in the future.
And the city is also taking action to reduce the overflow in the future. One example is Brandon Park, where workers are adding ways to trap rainwater and treat it there instead of sending it to the plant. Projects like this are planned throughout the city over the next 20 years. A quicker solution: build storage bins for the overflow. But that would cost twice as much. We're talking $300 million. In Lancaster, Caitlin Smith, News 8.
Now, the city has created a website to help educate residents about the problem and possible solutions. We've set up a link to that site on our website, WGAL.com.